So in February, the new Twitter CEO wanted $100 per month for access to its API. I mean, I'm barely capable of paying that much for health insurance. Last month, he started shutting off non-paying apps, which included the Emacs Twitter client, although he was nice enough to send me this application suspension notice. Now, not one of my millions of users have complained, since grieving is a five-stage process, and they're still in the first stage, which is denial. Hey Elon, if we had an Emacs Twitter client, your boy, Ron DeSantis, he'd be president by now. Waiving the fee for Emacs doesn't just support a text editor many of your employees use, it also supports independent developers who, as a demographic, are allergic to paying for anything. So Emacs continues to struggle to become an IDE. One effort by the LSP mode guy caught my attention. He moved the JSON RPC parsing out of single-threaded ELISP into its own thread in Emacs' internal C code. So here we have two threads, the top being the main thread and the bottom being the new JSON reading thread. The key insight is that JSON deserialization doesn't touch the LISP machine and can therefore be concurrent with the main thread. The callback processing, however, remains in LISP and thus necessarily continues to block the main thread. Remember, anything invoking LISP memory allocation is one at a time. Now, I wrote a test that inundates Emacs with 20,000 JSON messages. In the control case of a single thread, the JSON processing took 4.5 seconds. In the two-thread experimental case, the JSON processing took almost 3 seconds. So we're talking about a 50% improvement in speed, which is very promising. Now, this top diagram is a tad misleading because the deserialize step takes hardly any time, so the concurrency gain is limited to these red slivers of maybe 10 milliseconds. A span of time so insignificant as to call into question the whole point of concurrency. We can test this by moving deserialization back under the ELISP global interpreter lock to make it no longer concurrent. So this is where the new code deserializes the JSON message, and right now, it's in a critical region where the global lock is released. So what if we put it back under the global lock? Deserialization no longer current, concurrent. Recompile. Okay. Let's retest. And we can see here that it still takes roughly the same amount of time, almost 3 seconds. So, as suspected, the win isn't coming from the concurrency. So where is it coming from? In our current conception, the OS is giving two time units to the main thread for each one of the LSP thread. But the operating system really has no idea which is the main or the subsidiary thread. The more probable picture is below, where both the main and the LSP threads jump out of the starting gate at the same time, do whatever they can concurrently, and then the LSP thread waits for main to yield, at which point it can do its Lisp processing. So, at least according to this picture, a more equitable scheduling results in processing LSP messages sooner. This can be verified by capturing the timestamps of when Emacs begins to process a response. These white process slices here and here. What I found was the time to act upon a JSON message was not any sooner than the single-threaded control case. Yes, I remarked earlier that the bulk processing of 20,000 JSON messages was faster, but the more realistic dribs and drabs processing did not show appreciable gains. The timings for reaction time for the single-threaded control case had a mean time to react of roughly 147 milliseconds. And in the experimental two-threads case, it was actually a little slower at 163 milliseconds. So the final analysis was that introducing threads did not justify complicating the code for no appreciable gain. This goes to show that anyone with a personal agenda can concoct a test that either proves or disproves your performance claims. One thing novices, myself included, often get wrong is incorrectly assuming memory is consistent across threads. Just because I set X to 1 in thread A does not mean thread B sees it right away, if ever. Anyways, when testing, my main thread was caching data that the LSP thread wasn't seeing, and I suffered a seizure trying to debug it.